One of the most welcome knock-ons from the onset of the post-Rice era of the West Ham midfield is the consistent, high-quality all-round performances from Lucas Paqueta. Paqueta's out-of-possession contributions have been impressive. He presses with equal measures of intensity and intelligence, and is in the top 25% percentile across the big five leagues versus midfielders for tackles, aerials won and blocks, which is notable for a player given the bulk of attacking responsibility in the West Ham midfield. Further, whilst last season's attempts at build-up play were often funneled through Rice's switches of play slash ball carrying, the new dynamic often sees Paqueta conducting first phase build-up. He is usually the player to drop deep and seems encouraged to combine with Emerson as much as possible to progress the ball. The way they combine feels autonomous and improvised at times, and although it's uncharacteristic of his typical approach, David Moyes deserves credit for recognizing the pair's socio-effective utility. Alongside all these things, the most enjoyable evolution has been in Paqueta's creative abilities. Whether playing from the left and operating inside or roaming the midfield, Paqueta has established himself as the creative beacon of the West Ham team this season. Whilst he looked capable of being creative in 22/23, he's already over halfway to equaling his total XAR for last season, 1.4/2.7 XAR previous season, and has more than doubled his per 90 rate, 0.11 versus 0.24. Whilst the stats imply an improvement in creative output, watching Paqueta reveals some new tendencies that have enabled this upward trend. Specifically, he has often looked to receive in, and then create from the left and right half spaces, with his aim being to exploit the corridor of uncertainty with his passing. Not something we've seen much of until recently, e.g., assist for Bowen versus Lutt. This is something we regularly see from the Premier League's top creators, such as Kevin De Bruyne and Bruno Fernandes, with the half spaces being where they frequently do their best work. In a similar vein, Paqueta has also increasingly exhibited another Fernandes-like tendency, often disregarding the risk of a turnover in favor of playing risky but threatening passes. For example, Paqueta's attempts at through balls have more than doubled per 90 this year, from 0.71.53p/90, in line with what we historically see from Fernandes, 0.95 in 22/23. Just as you may observe a Fernandes over 90 mins, Paquetá is trying to continually create something for his teammates rather than playing safely. It's not about pass completion or ball retention, it's about creating threats and taking risks to do so. Further, as psychological research has demonstrated, taking risks in your decision-making is simply part of being truly creative. True creativity is a highly valuable individual trait at Premier League level. In general, as differences in players' abilities reduce, the intangible aspects of the individual, such as trait creativity or efficient use of perceptual tools, become more valuable in game winning. Of course, players with an obviously creative perception of the game, KDB, Bruno, Fabio Vieira, Paqueta are all good examples right now, require the ability to play the types of passes they perceive. Still, not all players with the ability to play these passes can perceive them. In the academic research surrounding professional football, sports scientists have increasingly looked to understand what differentiates creative and non-creative players. For example, researchers aiming to measure and profile professional footballers' decision-making suggest that creativity is enabled by cognitive flexibility. This refers to the adaptability of the individual's cognitive processes, which, in football terms, considers how well players can apply their cognitive problem-solving skills across a variety of situations with success. The suggestion is that increased cognitive flexibility enables players to generate solutions to problems in increasingly more difficult contexts, and the more difficult contexts are what drive the most creative actions. High cognitive flexibility suggests the player can adapt their on-pitch perceptions across various situations, like a Swiss Army knife for finding ways around defensive shapes. Some researchers take an even bigger step back in the decision-making process, considering how players use their eyes to pick up the relevant information to make a choice, and research using eye-tracking software finds that high- and low-level creative players significantly differ in this regard. The most creative players tended to fixate, focus their pupil on one spot, on many different areas in their visual field for short periods, short and frequent, whereas less creative players' fixations were longer and varied less locationally. In essence, the creative players looked at more stimuli on the pitch. Further, they fixated on more advanced zones and, most importantly, on teammates in threatening positions, e.g., unmarked on the last line, making forward run, etc., significantly earlier in a phase of play. The most creative players tend to look around more, prioritize their vision higher up the pitch, and perceive their most dangerously positioned teammates quickly. Whilst we can't test Lucas Paqueta to evaluate his visual fixation rate or ability to be cognitively flexible, the aim of this piece was to demonstrate that for the first time since Dimitri Payet, West Ham may have a truly creative player on their hands. These types of players come around rarely, and it's the smallest of individual differences that make them capable of regularly performing hard-to-perceive, but rewarding actions. Furthermore, hopefully you can take away some of the sports science underpinning creativity, using it to understand what makes people creative across the board.